skincare tips I wish I knew sooner. Let's go. First up,
I wish I knew earlier.
This is my skin before I started using peptides, and this was after.
My texture, my texture.
SPF. You want SPF every day, like your life depends on it.
This is starting with a good old benzoyl peroxide 4% wash.
Stay tuned for the results.
You can transform your skin from looking like this to looking like this by just changing the way you wash your face.
So let's get started.
Firstly, put some water and your cleanser into the skin. Your ultimate is made from a beautiful blend of natural and scientific ingredients.
Save or splurge, where I tell you what product is worth the splurge or if you should save your money.
How to achieve clean black skin.
So my perfect skin tutorial.
Everyone save your money. I'm going to tell you why you
love, love, love this. Absolutely get it.
It's just a grotesque postmodern psyop, and anyone who's fallen for this is brain damaged.
Nice job, Officer Fuckface. You really connected the dots on that one.
Well, it's official. I am now licensed!
Uh-oh, that sounds like...
Pedophilia.
It's just a grotesque postmodern psyop, and anyone who's fallen for this is brain damaged.
If I had to watch this atrocity, you have to too.
I hope we have a lot of sex. A lot.
I should have known his vows were gonna go like this.
You're screwed.
Only two things are required to keep me happy. Keep my belly full and my balls empty. Though you're amazing at half of it, we really need to get you some cooking lessons. Even when my belly isn't full, there is no one I could ever love more in this lifetime, unless I actually get a chance to meet Margot Robbie. Since the beginning, I was always told Life gets even better when the kids fall asleep and you tell me to come to the bedroom. Nothing's better than the sound of gagging and headboard slamming.
Michael.
P.S. Since you're so good at making decisions like Mary and me, you can choose whether tonight's going to end with being a toaster strudel or a Twinkie.
Alrighty. Being that I am his mom, I will deal with him later. He is grounded. By all means.
You go on that bio, you see an OF account. It's freely posting your bikini picture. She has too many provocative pictures. The lingerie photos, I think those are super private, super in-
I don't think so. It's the way it is, you know. Everything must come to an end. The drip finally stops.
I love a PSA after Halloween weekend. Straight girls are not welcome at gay club.
Story about me and bridal parties. I was in downtown Austin with some friends and my boyfriend. We were at a gay night, not a gay bar, but walk in and I see a bridal party. I tried to ignore it, I guess. But me and my boyfriend went to the bar to order a drink, and the bride's standing there with her like bride crown. She gets her drink, sips it very loudly. She's like, ew, this is disgusting. And then turns to my boyfriend and is like, do you want this? Looked at this fucking bitch. How dare you? A moment ago, you just said how disgusting it is, and you're offering it to my boyfriend? So that bride crown that she's wearing? I snatched that shit off of her head, threw it as far as I could, and looked straight in her face as her eyes were tearing up. Called her C-U-N-T. She ran on there with her bridal party very fast. Good. Cis ed people, get it through your thick skulls. We're not welcome in our spaces.
Imagine, in this big year, at your big age, getting on the internet as a white man and admitting to assaulting a woman. Quick question, do you keep the same energy with the straight men you encounter? Are you out there snatching baseball caps off guys' heads? Because something tells me you would not keep that same energy. Because if there's one thing that both you and I know about God's green earth, is that straight men in Texas bars, they're gonna throw some hands. And that, my friend, is likely a check that you are unable to cash. And it's the exact same reason why that girl did not throw hands at you. Why she left the situation in tears. Because you are bigger and stronger than her. Even though you are a gay man, you are still a man. You have this thing called testosterone in your body that gives you all that luxurious hair on your chest and the muscles to throw tiaras around with, and you weaponize that against a woman. Look, I get it. Bachelorette parties are fucking annoying. They annoy everybody. But let's not forget that you live in Austin, Texas. Outside of Nashville, this is like the mecca of bachelorette parties. But you even said in your video that this was not a gay club, this was a gay night, likely something that these girls had no idea about before they entered this establishment. But even if they had known, and even if this was a gay club, women go to gay bars to feel safe, something that I would hope you as a gay man would be able to understand and appreciate. To all my ladies out there, watch out for gay men like this, because just like with straight men, it's all fun and games until you bruise their ego, and their thinly veiled misogyny will come out in full effect.
Majority of women who vote Democrat are physically unattractive.
Hi, it's Pax, your favorite field epidemiologist. Now, this may surprise you, but did you know that women who identify as conservative are 10 times more likely to be shot by a spouse and murdered by a gun than liberal women? Women who identify as conservative are 2 to 3 times more likely to commit suicide than individuals who don't identify as conservative. Conservative women are 67 to 80% more likely to be victims of domestic violence. Conservative women have a life expectancy of 65 years, whereas liberal women have a life expectancy of 72 years. A cool stat, instead of like trying to provoke a response because I know the TikTok bubble told you to, maybe you should focus on not the attractiveness of liberal women or Democrat women, and instead focus on saving conservative women. Ugh.
So fuck all your gold stars, the cherries in the backyard.
me give you a reality check and explain to you why it's all men. Surefire way to piss me the fuck off is the comments I see you leaving on this. I have three sisters. Every single one of them, individually, have been essayed multiple times throughout their lives. More than me. Women feel the need when they meet someone new and they're going to go on a date for their safety. They feel the need to let someone know where they are going, who they are going on that date with, and what time they are going. Men do not feel the need to do that. It happens so often to women throughout their lifetime that they literally have to look at all men as potential predators. You and I don't need to do that with women. My youngest sister was raped when she was 13 years old by a 19-year-old man. Years later, after he got out of jail, people were saying that she needed to give him another chance and let him be a part of his daughter's life. And so, as uncomfortable as it was, my sister tried. That motherfucker tried to rape her again. The uncle to her son, a man that she had known for 6 years, tried to rape her. My sisters, when they go on dates, text me all the information that they have collected on the person, where they are going, what time they will be there. Some women feel so uncomfortable because of the amount of times they've been essayed in life that they have to have a friend who goes to the bar separately to keep an eye on them. Men do not have to do that. I'm a field service technician. I drive around a lot. I stop at a lot of stores. I get to know these people at these stores. And at one of these stores, there's this lady. She's really short. She's really tiny. And this motherfucker had visited that store 3 times that day, asking her. And she's told him no multiple times. She's told him she was with somebody. He didn't care. He continued. I stopped in that morning on my way through town to get a breakfast biscuit. When I got done doing service calls in the next town over, coming back, I stopped to get gas. I seen him there both times. And while I was in there, she told me he had been there 3 times that day, that he won't leave her alone. I pulled my truck around to the side of the building because I knew she was about to get off work and he was lingering. So she comes out of the store, he's still following her, follows her to the dumpster. She then strikes up conversation with a coworker at her car who's leaving and getting off work. He is lingering, he will not fucking stop. I clearly heard her tell him no and that she was with somebody. He didn't care. I had to have her get in my fucking truck before he would leave. It's all men, and you are part of the problem. I cry, I pray, mon Dieu. I cry, I pray, mon Dieu. Adieu, mon Dieu. Crucify, 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 like my Savior. Save, like the days of the time I pray. I crucify for the holy dimension.
It's so funny because the same men that will be screaming, not all men, when you say how great your man treats you, and you say that he like upholds all these standards, they'll be like, no, men don't do that. Like, he definitely is lying. Like, men are just terrible. Like, men are, And you're like, I thought we had to choose better men and that not all men did that. And now that I actually did choose better and have an amazing man, it's a problem. And you don't believe it because you think all men are trash.